Now, even as cases linked to Tablighi Jamaat continue to rise across the country, Delhi police has intensified its efforts to nab Maulana Saad, the chief organizer of the congregation at Delhi's Nizamuddin. The Delhi crime branch there visited the Marcus's office in Nizamuddin as part of their investigation. A five-member team from the Forensic Science Laboratory wearing hazmat suits collected some exhibits from the headquarters of the Tablighi Jamaat. Maulana Saad, along with six others, have been booked for violating government orders with respect to a religious gathering amid epidemic. So far, 1,095 cases linked to the Tablighi Jamaat gathering have come to fore. The South Delhi Municipal Corporation is mulling action against the Marcus building as it had permission for constructing only two floors, but now is a seven-story building.
जैसा कि हमारे संज्ञान में ये कल से आया है कि इस बिल्डिंग के अंदर करीब 1400 के करीब लोग उस इसमें अवैध रूप से रुके हुए थे और ये बिल्डिंग अवैध रूप से बनाई गई है. इसका कोई नक्शा नहीं पास है. जैसी हमें जानकारी मिल रही है, मैंने डीसी को इमीडिएटली ऑर्डर किया है कि इसके खिलाफ स्ट्रिक्टली एक्शन लेकर के इमीडिएटली सीन किया जाए और इनके खिलाफ पुलिस एफआईआर भी दर्ज कराई जाए जिन्होंने ये लापरवाही की है. ये कभी भी बर्दाश्त नहीं की जाएगी.
Let's quickly go over to our reporters joining us. Ashutosh from Delhi, Nilanshu from Lucknow, bringing us some more details. Ashutosh, we are looking at the surge of Tablighi Jamaat cases across of Delhi, a spike in the number of positive cases in the national capital itself. And we are seeing that the police, the crime branch, are going over to the Tablighi Jamaat premises, trying to collect some samples from there to see what could be done, how to go about containing the spread, ensuring that these members who are in hiding also come out and taken into confidence.
Well, a surge in positive cases, Nabila, as far as this entire congregation is concerned, itself contributes almost one-third of the total positive cases across the country from north to south, east to west. So that somewhere, of course, has been a criminal negligence at their part, and perhaps why the crime branch has been roped in to initiate a probe. So whereas the crime branch has started collecting, gathering evidences with the forensic lab team, other side, the SDMC has also initiated action. What we're hearing from the sources, that this Marcus, building, it had only permission of two floors. However, they made it up to six to seven, and in fact there are some irregularity as far as building construction and mapping is concerned. So clearly the SDMC sources saying they will be first issued notice, and perhaps there could be some process of demolition will also be initiated. So clearly the agencies, the enforcement agencies, including the Delhi Police Crime Branch and the Municipal Corporation, has now geared up to take strict action after the violation took place, because that's just not merely only breaking rule of law, but also putting hundreds of life in risk, because still all the states and center has been appealing people, those who were part of the congregation, came directly or indirectly in the test, must come out voluntarily and go for the test, opt for a test, or either go for the self-quarantine and isolation. So clearly, apart from the negligence, the hunting also being carried out by different state agencies, those who were part of the congregation. But yes, in the meanwhile, in the national capital, there is some action is going to happen against the Marcus.
Absolutely. There, Ashutosh, it's mandatory that Maulana Saad must be located and nabbed first. He should be held responsible for influencing thousands of those people there who were under his Jamaat, under his influence, heard his word, stayed indoors without maintaining social distance there, violating all those norms that were put in place or for a lockdown. Going over to Nilanshu, Nilanshu in Lucknow as well, several of those Jamaatis are still spread across, many of them worried to come out, fearing whatever it is, and showing absolute irresponsibility despite awareness being created by media there.
Well, this is absolutely right. More than 270 cases of COVID-19 have been reported in UP so far. And what we have been told from the state government is that nearly half of the COVID-19 patients are the Tablighi Jamaat attendees who attended the religious congregation in Nizamuddin. And most of the people who came in contact with the Jamaat attendees have been traced by the Uttar Pradesh government and the police. But police and the government believes that there are some people who are not cooperating with the government. The people who came in contact with the attendees are still hiding. They are not giving their details to the government. So yesterday, in the video conferencing that was chaired by Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, the video conferencing which was held by him, in which the clerics, the seers, and the prominent people belonging to every religion participated, the Chief Minister also urged the clerics to aware people that they should come out and get their samples tested, because somewhere they are also risking the lives of other people. So the police is trying to identify some people who came in contact with the Jamaat attendees. But the sample results of some of the people are also still awaited. It is expected to come out in the afternoon. So in Lucknow and in Varanasi, some of the areas have also been sealed as a precautionary measure by the state government. And today at 10 a.m., Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath will also be holding another meeting with the top officials.
Right, Nilanshu, let's hope that this sensitization program is effective enough for people to step out. The government has got to take them into confidence, either in through stringent measures or in the most sensitive way possible. They've got to understand it's about time. Do stay with us. We have more information coming in from the Health Ministry. The Health Ministry now also has blamed the Tablighi Jamaat congregation for the spike in coronavirus cases across the country. The ministry maintained that last month's Tablighi Jamaat gathering in Delhi has pushed up the doubling rate of cases in India to 4.1 days from the estimated 7.4 days. Of the 3,374 coronavirus cases on Sunday, 1,095 are linked to the Tablighi Jamaat. 232 fresh cases were reported on Sunday. All the 43 fresh cases in Telangana were linked to the Delhi event, while 85 cases were reported in Tamil Nadu. Uttar Pradesh reported 44 fresh cases. Meanwhile, Uttarakhand DGP Anil Rathori has warned the Jamaat participants to come out within 24 hours or face murder charges.
अगर हम तबलीगी जमात की घटना को और वो घटना ना हो उसको कंपेयर करें तो हमने देखा है कि जो हमारा डबलिंग रेट यानी कि कितने दिनों में केस डबल होते हैं वह करीब 4.1 है अभी वो अगर ये घटना नहीं होती और ये एडिशनल केसेस हमारे नहीं आते तो वह करीब 7.4 डेज होती
हमने उनका पूरा ट्रैकिंग कर लिया है जो यहाँ से गए कितने वापस आए कितने नहीं आए तो वो कहाँ पर हैं और जो बाहर से यहाँ आए वो कब वापस गए और अभी यहाँ पर हैं तो कहाँ पर हैं वो पूरा हम उसका ट्रैकिंग कर रहे हैं दूसरा कुछ लोग अभी हाल के दिनों में खासकर निजामुद्दीन की घटना के बाद कुछ लोग यहाँ पर आए हैं चोरी छिपे तो ऐसे लगभग 30 लोगों पे हमने मुकदमा दर्ज किया FIR दर्ज की है क्योंकि वो ऐसा करके वो लॉकडाउन के नियमों का पालन नहीं कर रहे
Let's quickly go over to Ashish joining us from Hyderabad. Ashish Pandey, thank you for speaking to us, risking your own life. Our reporters are the true corona warriors. We should say that time and again. They are out there bringing us all the details amid this pandemic, this crisis. Ashish, we know that in Hyderabad, across of Andhra, Telangana, we're seeing a surge in positive cases and many of them linked back to the Tablighi Jamaat.
Yes, you are absolutely right, Nabila, and good morning. Today, from Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, if you talk about the cases related to Tablighi Jamaat, almost over 80% of the cases from both the states are directly or indirectly linked to Tablighi Jamaat. If you talk about the total number of cases, positive cases in Andhra Pradesh, it's 259 cases. Yesterday, state witnessed 60 new cases, and all 60 cases are directly or indirectly associated or linked to Tablighi Jamaat congregation in Delhi. Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh is under Rayalaseema region. It has witnessed maximum 49 cases in past 24 hours from between Saturday to Sunday. In Telangana, maximum cases are in Hyderabad. Hyderabad is the epicenter or hotspot. We can say almost 145 cases are in and around Hyderabad. Total 62 cases were reported in a single day on Sunday as per government data. While total numbers of positive cases are 289. Telangana also has 11 deaths. All these deaths directly or indirectly related to Tablighi Jamaat congregation. If we talk about people who participated in this meeting from both the Telugu states, it's almost over 2,000 people who participated in this event in mid-March in New Delhi. So now both the government are working together, different agencies are working together. They are trying to identify, isolate all these positive cases and the relative of or close contact of all these positive cases. Isolation drives are on, particularly Rayalaseema, Kurnool district of Rayalaseema, where 49 cases have been reported. There, the whole focus is in Andhra Pradesh. in Hyderabad and around Hyderabad, the Telangana government is keeping a close watch. So yes, both the states are working hard to keep the case or number low and also curtail any possible death.
Right, Ashish, I just hope people show some responsibility there. Thank you so much for joining us with those details.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.